What's the craziest thing you've ever done in your life?
The craziest thing is to dress like this. Yes, yes, I did not imagine myself. My name is Fatima. I am 39 years old and I came from Bulacan, Philippines. I came from a Christian family background and I could say that I have a very strong foundation of Catholicism in my family, as my grandmother is a pastoral counselor in our church, and so does my uncles, who used to have this kind of Catholic teaching in Saudi until now. As for myself, I was able to teach also catechism in my secondary years, whereby I was able to teach the elementary pupils about religion as well. Before I could recall myself saying that I hate Muslims, because what my impression about them is that they were people of terrorism. I was just living opposite of this center, and outside of this center it says Beauty of Islam. Out of curiosity, I came in without planning, and I just took my courage to at least defend my religion. I would defend Papa Jesus, as I would call him that time, and I would defend Mama Mary, because I used to call them during the time whenever I pray. So it was my intention to defend myself as a Christian that time. When I came here and I started to listen, I was really trying to deny whatever I heard from the Sheikh, because whatever he said that time was actually acceptable in my own logical thinking, but I don't have the courage to accept it verbally. It was a realization on my part that there's something wrong in my belief. I scared about the rejection of my family. As I have said, I came from a very religious background. I came from a very strong Catholic family. And from the time that I realized that my grandmother would be hurt, my uncle would get upset, and they may reject me as a family member, that really was a big factor on my part. I was afraid of transforming myself into something that I don't, and I was not really prepared of. I find myself here again, and then everything is settled, but I am not aware that am I going to accept Islam as my religion, because the fear of rejection is really stronger than my plan of conversion. I came to realize that there will come a day that we will be standing in front of our Creator, that there were people who had given me the message and yet I have not accepted. And by that time, the reality of life is, the certainty of life is our death. So what if something happens to me when I get home that night, and then after telling that I have accepted the truth, I still did not bother to testify. So by that time, everything got erased in my head. My family, my children, everything, my friends, the fear of rejection just totally erased. And then I happen to feel like I'm imagining myself standing in front of my Creator. And that is the time when I made my shahada. Islam teaches me how to be more compassionate towards my parents, towards my grandparents especially. Before, you never know the value of respect. You put your parents, especially your mother, to the highest position, because in Islam we believe that in their feet lies the paradise. I learned the value of time. I learned the value of my spiritual aspect. I learned the value of my submission and the purpose of life, especially because before you were just living as if the time goes by, then let's do whatever it takes. But now, every second counts. You never know when is the time that you'll be facing your Creator, so the preparation is there. You're not going to focus in this dunya alone, in this world alone, but you are going to prepare for the hereafter, which you have to be really afraid of. Being rejected by people is no means, is not at all a means for you to deny that there is only one God. And the only turning point that we can assure of our salvation is to submit to His will and be a Muslim.